Baby metal. Metal-y. Let's go. Hey there. Well, this is it. This is the last of the run of episodes showing you the chronological history of baby metal, made mainly for my sister, who asked me a long time ago, what is a baby metal? And I wanted to close out with this video because it is reminiscent of one of the earliest videos that I showed you. And that one is Megetsune. And we will kind of do a comparison here, at least verbally. But first, I want you to see this. This is a collaboration with Tom Morello, a very prominent guitarist here in the West. And baby metal more and more often seems to be doing collaborations, which is great because it mixes them up with the metal community. So this is Metal-y. It's like a festival, okay? So here we go. I love this video. Here we go. Cool. That song is great fun, and I can't say enough about it. I was super pleased when I saw it first time. So I told you that I felt like it showcased Momo very well, and it did it in a background similar to Megetsune. Now, when we talked about Megetsune, if you recall, this was sort of a coming out for Sue. It was sort of her breaking out of, moving from childhood to adulthood, and the decision, choices she was going to have to make becoming an adult. How much of herself to hide, how much of herself to show, or who she was showing herself to be. So in this one, the theme of breaking with tradition is very strong. And it's shown when they're in the shrine. What they're doing are several things to break with tradition and yet maintain a traditional look. All right, first of all, we're in the shrine, which is reminiscent of Megitsune's stage. If you remember, that's what they were doing. They were a dojo or a shrine. Three together, again. This is the other one. This is the new baby metal, newer baby metal, or the other baby metal. And Momo is now the one breaking out and breaking tradition along. They're all doing it, but what I'm saying is Momo's now included in this. So it's sort of like a showing it again, because this is the other baby metal. But we're still who we are. So they're going to show you in a couple of ways here. First one is, they're wearing boots. And in a shrine, you must go barefoot. Okay, right here, you see these items, the tea services. These are traditional items in the shrine or in the dojo. They're wearing the boots, and they're going to kick these over as a sign of breaking with tradition. Moa has such a great smile, and she's such a kidder on stage. All right, so more breaking of tradition coming here, the breaking out feeling. See the breaking through the bamboo screens? Now these shouts that you're hearing and the shouts that we do is in the crowd back to baby metal are shouts of encouragement. And at festivals, they use these shouts to encourage people carrying very heavy, holy stones and rocks in certain types of settings. So the crowd shouts its encouragement. It's like us doing the same thing. And I think I might have explained this to you before. So here we go. Okay, now we're outside in the festival atmosphere. Now we're going to move forward here. I want to show you where I think Momo breaks out and why they put and they use her for it. It's her reciting this phrase, and what she's doing is a move in Kabuki theater. And it is the climax of a song or a recitation by a Kabuki actor, traditionally male. In fact, never female. These Kabuki artists come out of various schools. And when they do this move, the audience, when they complete the move, the audience shouts back the name of the school from which that actor has come from. So here's what Momo is going to do it for us.
Metali. Metali.
So when she's saying Metali and doing that shake, excuse me, in Kabuki theater, that's the climax of a performance. And at this point, the crowd shouts out the name of the school that this particular mode came from. It's kind of like us understanding genre of music, but only it's theater. It's Kabuki theater. So let me back up here. This whole thing is the Kabuki theater leading up to Momo's climactic moment. You can see the Kabuki masks, the traditional dancing down low where they're practically crab walking across the stage. That's Kabuki.
Metali.
And then we're out of the song. I thought this was a great way to present Momo Metal. And I loved every second of this video. I absolutely think this song is a banger. So that's it. We're done. And I brought you up to the point where Baby Metal is, this is this album. And there's plenty of it released, I imagine, all over the internet. But you can buy the album from Amazon, or you can buy it from Baby Metal's website. A little, might be a little more difficult to do that. I think you can get this on Amazon, though, by now, I would hope. So, it's all Blu-ray. You can get a lot of live performances. Outside of the four albums that I told you about, those are just production studio albums. There are plenty of compilations and best ofs, you know, and live performance Blu-rays for entire concerts. So you'll want to check those out as well. Well, I love you, little lady, and I'm going to get out of here now. Folks, thank you for joining us and watching this series with us. It was very lightweight, does not delve deeply, gets it wrong in certain parts, but there's so much lore surrounding Baby Metal that you can spend a lifetime studying this band. So that's what I'm going to do. And there'll be plenty more Baby Metal to come on this channel. Only now, it's going to be freeform. So, all right, well, I got to get out of here, like I said. So I'll see you later. Bye now.